volunteer. Full agenda this morning. First thing on the item is acceptance or correction of the previous minutes of 4/28. Is there a motion?
I move they be accepted as amended.
Seconded. Seconded by Hank. Bob, amendments?
In the people that were here, I think there was a person missing. I don't know the person's name, but Wendy Goddard, who testified at the was not alone.
Right, and he didn't leave his name, and I didn't recognize him.
Okay.
I mean, I realized there was somebody else with him. He didn't speak, so we didn't get his name.
I didn't sign it. I know it was her husband.
It's Mrs. Wendy Goddard?
I don't think so.
Yeah, let's just be careful.
Okay.
On page 4, second paragraph. The sentence reads, the town administrator brought up the request to relinquish Emerald Circle. Before Emerald Circle, I would suggest that we insert the cul-de-sac off.
Yep.
It's not a big ticket, but on that same page, the public hearing, everything's jammed into.
Yeah.
I think it's probably a three-paragraph paragraph. When we get to separate issues.
Yeah.
All right. My English teacher said if it's too harsh, it's two holes. And on page 3, there's a paragraph that starts out Vice Chairman Henry Boyle. I think that second sentence belongs down after the motion. It's out of order and it makes the motion look a little silly. That's it for me.
Yeah, on page 5, midway down, the town administrator explained RSA 41, blah, blah, blah. I think after that it would say perhaps allowing the selectmen to.
There's no clarification on it.
I mean, it sounds nice, but unless you, for me with the RSAs, it doesn't mean much.
Set, Bruce? Anything
yep.
Further?
No, sir.
All those in favor?
Aye.
400, John.
Yep.
Thank you. Next item is public comment. Yes, Marlene.
I know you people already know this, but I wanted to come in anyway and tell you that we've broken another record for the month of April. We took in $169,852.59. And 2 weeks of that was with full staff in there, and 2 weeks of that was with down staff. So I just thought you people would like to know if we did break out the record. I think it's like almost a third more than last year.
Yeah, it's a lot of money.
Yeah, it is.
And that's a record because last year was a big record of 120.
It seems so we ought to have a party celebrating some of these records sometime.
I guess that's that's really all I have to say. I just wanted to come in and solve it.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah, thank you very much, Marlene.
Yeah, I'd like to compliment you, especially with the short staff, and that you still got your sanity and you're not in a rest home.
That's imbalance, huh?
You and the people helping you did very, very well.
Good. Thank you very much.
That's all I have.
Thank you. Anybody else, public comment? All right, we'll do, well, we have a 10 o'clock, a 9:10. If the people that are here for 9:10 can wait a couple of minutes.
Sure.
Okay, thank you. We'll move down to Selectmen's discussion, old business. Yeah, I guess, because it wasn't mentioned at public comment. That's why I asked.
John, I looked at him and it was quiet.
At your request, you're moving down to old business.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, because that's why we had public comment, so it's not going to come in on the public comment.
Right.
It's the only place on the agenda that we can put it.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There was a special meeting of the Budget Committee that was called for Thursday evening. The issue that we have already discussed mm-hmm. before was discussed again. The piece that was given to us last Monday with those changes
right.
was pretty much the piece that was voted on by the Budget Committee, exclusive of everything that was below. Okay? So that piece that we have, whereby the Budget Committee would like us to participate in the process that we've described, but without any of the conditions that exist. Let the committee go forward. If it is to go forward, let them determine once they receive their charge what it is that, and how they're going to go forward. But in the piece that we had, binding arbitration was mentioned in the third step. None of those steps are there. Okay, what the Budget Committee approved was to establish the committee by the Budget Committee, have two members from the Board of Selectmen, two members from the School Board, and two members from the Budget Committee, and report back to the Budget Committee. That's okay. The essence of that. And so, I told them I'd bring it to the board, and it was, I abstained from the vote because it was coming here and I had to bring it here, but the vote was unanimous with the exception of my abstention. So there was discussion for about an hour. It was thoroughly discussed, but it was unanimously approved. Is that?
That's correct.
Okay.
Yeah, with the exception of taking the items out at the bottom of the last week. The only other change was one line added that said that the Budget Committee Chairman would have the School Subcommittee Chairman be given the authority to do whatever necessary to get this rolling without going back to the Budget Committee. Because we only meet once in a while this time. Request to the Budget Committee establish a review board with the best allegations of misuse of public funds as required in the statute. We're requesting that the selectmen participate in that. We request that the school board participate in that, so that panel 60 for the review of the allegations on both sides of the information. So, because this represents an opportunity for us to solve our own problems without a level of extra expenditure that comes through litigation, I'll bring the motion forward. I'll make that a motion come before the board.
everything is the same then that was on there, does that refer to the RSA that gives this Budget Committee that?
Both 3222 and 91AA.
And I'm going to, I don't want to assume, I'd like to be able to assume, but I just want to make sure, so that is basically following the authority that's given to the Budget Committee and the RSA and nothing more. Is there any further discussion? Bruce?
Now, has the school board notified you that they're going to go along with this in any manner?
I'll be meeting with them tonight. I've had informal discussions with a number of committee meeting members.
But the answer is no.
The answer is no at this time.
Any comments or questions?
No.
Is there any further discussion on this? Seeing none?
There has been no second.
I apologize. I'll second it for discussion.
I don't think we should even be discussing this until we know what the school board stand is. This whole thing hinges upon the school board participating. If it does not participate...
That's right.
So... I know what the school board feels about it before I even discuss it.
Well, yeah, I think we could all sit around and get to age 100, waiting for somebody else to go first. We happen to meet first. I would hope that we would go forward. Now, if you want to put it on the condition that the school board, I think that's required within the motion itself.
Is that in the motion that you made?
What puts in the motion is that there has to be two and two. Obviously, if the school board doesn't participate, then all bets are off.
But, well, I guess my question is, Bob, is that specifically in the motion that you made, that it's subject to...
I think it's much like the sentence, go to the store, you as understood.
Okay, you feel that it's in there, then okay.
I'll ask one more question.
Okay.
Is the motion, Bob, consistent with the first paragraph or the first two paragraphs?
First two.
The first two paragraphs. I don't see how RSA 91-A:8 applies to this, number one. And paragraph two, second sentence kind of confuses me. The first sentence computed a quick no-cost close. There's going to be costs involved. There's going to be legal fees on both sides if this thing goes to conclusion. Because the only redress the Budget Committee has in this is to ask for these people to be removed legally. Which involves an attorney.
I respectfully disagree. And that's one thing that we should not do, is we should not take a look at this, put in our own individual analysis of what we think the problem is, and then come to a conclusion. I think that's the task of the committee. And I think there are a wide variety of options that could happen. I don't think there is any one set of conclusions that fits. That's part of what we had, a discussion that we had at the Budget Committee level, is we had a couple of members that were quite clear in what they felt the conclusions would be. And it was expressed by most people there that that's not it, all right? You may have a private perspective, but until you get to the point of examining exactly what happened and share it with other members of the committee, I think it's unfair to get to the end line, that point of conclusion, and say, this is how it's going to be. Because in reality, nobody knows how it's going to be, or in fact, exactly what the issues will be. Because that process has not been investigated.
Bruce?
The Budget Committee meets with the school board. Say they go ahead and meet. school board will turn around and ask for a lawyer to be present. Naturally, they'll want their attorney present. The selectman will be there without an attorney present. Will the budget committee have an attorney present? Because you know darn right well that the school board is going to want to have their attorney present at all these hearings. That's my question for you.
Okay. No, I don't know downright well that that's exactly what the school board would want to do. Is that a possibility? Yes. Is it possible that they could adopt the view that's expressed by the committee, that it be done without litigation? Yeah, I think that's possible, because ultimately this committee would have to report back to the budget committee its findings, whatever they are. Then the budget committee is going to have to do some discussing. Then it would go back, I would think, to the school board if there was anything to go back to the school board, if that's what the budget committee concluded. I think when you say, I want to inject attorneys throughout this process, that defeats, in my view, what the process is all about. All right? What it's all about is trying to solve your own problems without benefit of legal intervention. Because if we get into a legal situation, like we said at the first part of the discussion, the taxpayers pay for both sides of the issue. We're trying to avoid that. Maybe it's not possible. I don't know. But I'd like to give it a shot.
Okay.
Just a comment. I think the taxpayers are already paying for the school. I have no doubt that the school is looking for legal answers on some of these questions right now. So the taxpayers are already paying legal fees on one side.
On one side.
Yeah.
And if we allow it to go to its natural conclusion, they'd be going to both sides unless we intervene.
Is there any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor? All those opposed? It's defeated 2-2. Zero.
I make a motion that we can table until next meeting. We hear back from the school board.
To table what?
Motion's defeated.
Motion to table.
It's not on the table anymore.
Oh.
It's defeated.
Motion was defeated. We can bring it up if the school board wants.
Yeah. Fine. Barbara indicated last week, thanks for holding an on-agenda item. Anyway, any further discussion on this item? Seeing none, we'll move back to, we have a 9-10 appointment. Non-public session, RSA 91-A, semicolon 3, parenthesis II, parenthesis D.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I was going to ask the administrators.
That's land negotiation.
In simple terms. We have a motion for non-public session.
So moved.
Seconded by Hank. All those in favor? That's 400. Roll call.
Yes.
Bruce?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And we'll be going into non-public session.